So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new FIFA 21 video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with Liverpool, in my opinion of course, at this moment. I'm going to show you the best formation, lineup, tactics and instructions. I already made two videos about Liverpool before that were different formations, and yeah, some people like to play more realistic how Liverpool plays in real life. So I was trying this 4-3-3 formation. And yeah, I can say that this is a really, really wonderful formation, really attacking formation, quick attacking gameplay. So if you are interested in that, try it out yourself, set everything up the same like I did in the instructions and the tactics and all that stuff. Try it out yourself. Let me know in the comments what you think of it and what your results are. But first of all, I want to thank you very much for watching. Please drop a like under the video if you think this video is really useful for you. You could also subscribe to my channel. It's free to do, of course. I'm doing lots of tactic videos. I'm doing tutorial videos, gameplay videos. I'm also streaming live on Twitch sometimes. So if you're interested in watching me there, go to the link in the description and yeah, follow me on Twitch also. And then we are going to start. The formation is the 4-3-3 false number 9. Formation. The lineup: Alisson is the goalkeeper, Alexander Arnold the right defender, Gomez and Van Dijk are the center backs, and Robertson is the left defender. Fabinho is the most defensive midfielder, two central midfielders, Henderson and Wijnaldum. On the right side of the attack, we have Salah, we have Roberto Firmino playing as the central forward, and Mane is the left winger. Then we're going to the tactics. I choose press after possession loss with a width of 5 bars and a depth of 5 bars. So when you are losing the ball, your players are going to press and try to get the ball back. And with all these fast attackers, with Salah, with Mane, you also have Firmino, and you have two really wonderful central midfielders with Wijnaldum and Henderson. Really fast, really aggressive on the ball. So there is a really good opportunity that you're recovering that ball back really soon when you are losing it.
And here we're recovering the ball with Gomez, Fabinho to Wijnaldum, and also Mane is making those run. We lose the ball and then you can see how the pressure works. Look at this. Wijnaldum is going to press immediately on Walker. And I don't know who this is. I think it's Robertson who is going to cover the space by De Bruyne. Fabinho is here. Henderson and Mane are here. So there is not a really good option for Manchester City to play the ball. And yeah, that's what the pressure on press after possession loss is doing. And yeah, Walker doesn't know what to do. Wijnaldum can get the ball. Mane to Firmino. Salah cutting inside and scoring the goal.
Then we're going to the offensive style. I choose balanced with a width of 7 bars. Plays in the box 6 bars. Corners and free kicks both 3 bars. I choose balanced because that is really, for me, the best offensive style in this game. Because when you have the ball and there is an opportunity to counterattack, the players will recognize that, and maybe also because the instructions that we are giving them. But they are making some runs forward, and you can give them through balls and create really good chances. But when there is not a really good opportunity, when you are going back yourself or holding up the play a bit, they will stop running, making themselves available and play more like possession football. So that's why I'm liking this offensive style balanced the most. Then we're going to the instructions, and these are really, really important. Alexander Arnold joined the attack at overlap runs. So he's going to make some runs at the sideline and yeah, doing his thing where he's good at. You can pass the ball to him, he can cross the ball, he can pass the ball. He is really good at that, so that's what he is doing. The same for Robertson, join the attack and overlap run. And yeah, that's because of the wingers that we are playing. I'm going to show you that later, but they are going to cut inside, and when they are cutting inside, there is a lot of space at the side of the field, and that is where Alexander Arnold and that is where Robertson are running into. And yeah, you have an extra attacker when they running forward, so that's really, really amazing.
In this situation, I'm going to show you what the join the attack overlap runs for Robertson is doing, also for Trent Alexander-Arnold. You see the great run he was making there.
Two center backs are just default. Fabinho, the most defensive midfielder, cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking and cover center. because already the two fullbacks can go forward if they want. So Fabinho needs to stay back to cover up the space between your midfield and the defense. Henderson, get forward, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. So he is making runs forward, and that is a really wonderful job in this formation. The same for Wijnaldum, get forward, get into the box for the cross and cover center. And these two guys are, I think, the most important in this formation because they are making such lovely runs forward. They can pass the ball really good. They can score goals even, showing up in the box on time. And yeah, you can create wonderful, wonderful chances because sometimes you are with six or seven people together attacking, and there is so much players and so many opportunities to pass the ball, combinations, and create lovely, lovely chances.
And here we have a really great example from Firmino, who is here in the middle circle, and yeah, he's making himself available for a pass, and we're gonna play it a bit, and then you can see these two center backs from Manchester City are totally focused on Firmino. And what now is going to happen is you can see Wijnaldum here, he's already making a run, and look at this wide gap in the defense of Manchester City. And also Henderson is running forward, you see Mane, you see Salah, everybody is running forward, and look how really great you can have a good attack here with Mane and his speed. And you can see Wijnaldum is in the box, Henderson is in the box, Salah is in the box, and Firmino is also almost in the box. So lots to choose, and we're choosing the best option, Wijnaldum, and scoring the goal.
Then we're going to Salah, cut inside, get in behind, get into the box for the cross. So he's starting at the side of the field, but when there is an opportunity in the center, he will cut inside, and with his speed, nobody is going to catch him up. And yeah, you can score lovely goals by one-on-one goalkeeper chances if you give him on the right time a through ball.
And here you can see Henderson having the ball to Firmino, and look at the space there is in the middle of the defense for Manchester City. Salah has recognized that because he has the instruction to cut inside, and Firmino is here. You can see he's taking the central defenders with him, and there is so much space for Salah to go here. Even Wijnaldum can go there, and Mane is going there. So there's lots and lots of space for our fast attackers to make a good run and create a really good chance. Salah really fast, of course, faster than Cancelo is. A waste of the chance, but almost the goal. But you see how lovely these instructions are.
Yeah, the same for Mane. Cut inside, get in behind, and get into the box for the cross. The same as Salah. He's cutting inside when there is a really good opportunity and create your chances. And there is so much space in the center of the field, and that's because of Firmino. Stay central and false number nine. And what this false number nine does is he drops into the midfield to create attack space for teammates. And that is exactly what this does. He is dropping into the midfield. The center backs of your opponent are coming with him. So there is a lot of space he is creating in the center of the field. Salah and Mane are cutting inside where there is no center back at all. Give them these through balls, and voila, you can have your goal scoring chances. And even Wijnaldum and even Henderson make profit of this Firmino by stay central and false number nine, because he is dropping into the midfield and these two guys are getting forward. So they run through him, whatever. And yeah, Firmino is going back. These two guys are going forward. So your center backs of your opponent are running forward also, and Wijnaldum and Henderson dive into those gaps and create lovely, lovely chances.
And now we have a situation again. Firmino is making himself available for a pass as a false number nine. Wijnaldum is making the run forward, and what you're gonna see here is that Mane is cutting inside already, because there's a really, really wide gap in the defense of Manchester City, and with his pace, he is faster than Walker is, can get into the box for the cross and can score. It was an awful finishing for myself, but we should have scored there. But you can see there how great this cut inside for Mane is. Here we have Wijnaldum having the ball. You see Firmino is making himself available to receive a pass. Wijnaldum is giving that, and look what the center backs of Manchester City are doing. They are going both to Firmino, and what that does is creating a really wide gap here in the middle of the defense of Manchester City. And what Mane is going to do, cut inside. Salah should cut inside. I don't know if he's doing that here, but no, he doesn't. But Mane does that and making a really good run, receiving the ball from Henderson, and with his pace he can go one-on-one on the goalkeeper and score a goal. Too bad we didn't score, but you see that it was a really, really great opportunity.
So I hope you understand what I'm all saying. I'm giving you some examples with gameplay also, so I think it is to understand. And yeah, if you have some questions, let me know in the comments. I will try to answer them, of course. But try this out yourself. It's really lovely, and hopefully you will win with this, of course. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.